to say. And then, you know, opportunity, you're so lucky that opportunities just come to you one after another. And yes, I just want to tell him that he is so lucky.
You got me all tearing up.
Oh my God.
No, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Today is my birthday and I'm turning 40, the big 4-0. It's supposed to be a big thing. Today is actually really special and I am launching a brand new collection. It's completely a brand new concept, but it's actually a passion of mine. I've been working on this concept for over a decade and finally, this is the right time to share this collection with you. You're welcome. After my 40th, so next, hopefully, you know, we'll be back to normal. We'll be back to normal so then I can be creative and I can create more beautiful things for all of you guys. You have seen me, over the year, you have seen what I have done on the red carpet or what I've done for you, my princesses and my prince, and especially on Say I Do, you can see what I can do for you on your special day. And I just wanna, you know, we can just, you know, get over this. And I know we will get over this and we will be okay. And so we can be back to normal and I can just create more beautiful things for you guys. It's a beautiful world out there and I just wanna create beautiful things for a beautiful world for all of you beautiful people. If I was at home, then we would celebrate differently. But if I was on set or traveling, then we have to celebrate differently. But no matter what, I know for my birthday and Kevin's birthday is only 4 days apart, we will always celebrate together. Over the past 40 years, I think the one lesson that I keep on going back and back and back, and I think it was a hard lesson for me to learn when I was younger, especially in my 20s, is take your time. Don't rush. There's many decisions that I've made before. I made some quick and rushed decisions. I wish I hadn't. It wasn't like a bad decision that hurt me or hurt other people, but trust me, take your time. Don't rush. Don't rush into your decision and take your time, do your research and do what's right for you and everyone around you. I think I would definitely tell him that you're so lucky. You're so lucky and that you get to be in this world. And at such a young age, at 9, you knew what you want to do. You want to jump on that machine and learn how to sew. You want to be creative. And you're so lucky that you're the only child, that your parents have sacrificed so much to get you to the United States. So you have the freedom. The freedom to follow your dream. The freedom to follow your passion. The freedom to express yourself, but and then yet not knowing if you can do all that, but yet you get so lucky to arrive in the United States in such a small town that you don't know anything. You were in the shelter. You were just absorb. You were like this sponge. You're absorbing everything, and you're so lucky that your parents let you do whatever you do. And you realize that and you see that and you are so responsible to do things, to do good things, to get to where you are today. And you're so lucky that you don't know anything else but just work, work, work. And you have worked. Forever, you have worked nights and day. You have worked when people just, you know, don't pay you. You have worked when people take advantage of you. You have worked so you cannot give up. And you worked until And you're so lucky that you just find ways, and you just, you're so lucky that you meet so many great people that just want to help you. And then you're so lucky that you meet the love of your life who just support you all the way. His family, my family, everybody who worked with me, the whole team. So I just have to say, and then, you know, opportunity, you're so lucky that opportunities just come to you one after another. And yes, I just want to tell him that he is so, so, so lucky. I think that's when I recognized that is when I first opened my professional studio. At that time, I didn't call it an atelier yet. I call it a studio because it was just a small space for me to explore and learn. And that's when I was like, you know what? I have to pay rent. I have to be responsible for whatever I created and whatever I deliver to the customer. That's when I realized that I'm not in college anymore. I'm not experiment with my product anymore. I need to stand behind my product. And that's when I realized that quality in your product is the most important thing. The one thing, thank you for this question, and I share this answer to every single student when I have an opportunity to talk to student at university. Whatever you do, doesn't matter what happened to you, don't ever give up. Those words don't exist in my vocabulary. So it doesn't matter what happened. I believe when you hit bottom, you will go up. You cannot go any more but bottom. And the one thing is, you'll be gone if you give up. So if you don't give up, you will go up. It's definitely a difficult struggle that I have been, you know, working since I knew I want to be a designer. And the thing is, I want to keep my name as Thai Nguyen, or in Vietnamese we call it Thai Nguyen. Many people who've seen my work, and sometimes they don't even want to say the name. You know, they just want it to belong to like the work belong in some fashion house, like an American name or a European name, but they never want to say the, you know, Thai Nguyen. But on the Met Gala, when E interviewed Lala Anthony, her publicist and Lala want to learn how to pronounce my name, and she said my name beautifully on the Met Gala. So that's one thing I have to thank Lala Anthony again. Not until about 4 years ago that I found a publicist that agreed to showcase my name as Thai Nguyen Atelier. Kind of like, you know, this is what I share in an inclusion talk before. And I feel like we still think that as Vietnamese American or Asian in general, we still feel like we are the help when it comes to a lot of industry, like especially creative industry, fashion, film, TV. We always think that we are not first priority. And so when I get the opportunity to showcase myself as a Vietnamese American with my name, it's so big and it's so overwhelming, and I'm so proud. So as the moment when I heard I got to be on Say I Do as one of the hosts, and even when I get to set, I was like, oh my god, I'm always that behind the scene guy. I was never the star, and I didn't even think I'm the star. I didn't know that I'm the star until the show launched on Netflix. I think the entertainment industry, I want the entertainment industry to serve you, then define you. Because a lot of time, people are in the entertainment industry and they're like, to be like this, I have to be like that, I have to be a certain image, and I have to act like this, I have to treat people like this. No, you don't have to. The entertainment industry could be two ways. It could help you and elevate you, and you just be yourself and be authentic, and people just love you and love you and love you and love you. Or if you are not authentic and not real, the entertainment will showcase that, and the whole journey of you being in that industry, you have to be fake, you have to lie, you have to strategize, and it's just a lot of work. And to me, I think in life, I want to be able to go to sleep peacefully every night. And the best way to do that is be yourself. Be authentic, be who you are, and just literally do good. Be good and do good. I've shared this before, like when I was younger, I was just kind of like a wallflower. I just kind of sit in the corner and I absorb, and I don't talk to a lot of people. I don't share a lot of things. I keep everything private, but I absorb everything. And then I don't like to smile when I was taking picture, and I don't like to be autographed. And all of a sudden now, I love having picture taken, and I love to smile. I love to have fun. I still love to see and absorb things, but then I love to express myself and showcase things. So the entertainment can bring out the best of you if you are real and authentic, and it's the best way. It's the best tool, it's the best platform to showcase your authentic self. Okay, it's just like 60 minutes
yeah,
with Barbara Walters.
This escalated.
Arugula.